All right, guys, wanted to make this video after some requests and after the, kind of thinking and the realization, a lot of these interior sets and these buildings, some of you may have only seen if you've seen them maybe on my Twitter or Instagram, or if you follow some of the Facebook groups that I do. But if you guys haven't seen them on there, then you might have never seen these. So I figured I could do just a whole rundown, just kind of go down the line here and kind of pull back the curtain, as I guess you'd say, and let you see what some of these builds are, and just kind of give you my perspective on them, as it attributes to how I build them in the game and how I leave them or how I set the scene up. Because sometimes, me building in this game is just, there's really no reason beyond wanting to create a scene. Like, sometimes I'll just build stuff in the game that will never be used, or, as far as even a ride goes or in a park, but that's what brings a lot of enjoyment, of the game to me. Is like, I'll see a movie or, see something on TV or at a theme park, and I will just come down here and set and be like, I am building, I'm going to build that scene. So, and that's where it ends. And, that's okay with me, because that's what I enjoy about this game. I think sometimes I enjoy that more than building coasters or starting whole big new parks. It's just the thought of just jumping in and knowing in a couple hours I'm going to, be able to put something in the game that I visualized maybe a week ago or maybe last night, and then getting to put that out there and share it and, be like, check this out, guys. Here's the scene from The Shining I just came up with, and getting your all's reaction. And that is a really fun aspect of the game for me, and I think it's really why it really helps contribute to me not getting burnt out per se. And it's another thing I think that that attributes to my enjoyment of the game. I don't really hold myself back for like, okay, I don't start a series and then it's like, okay, part one, and then a couple days later, part two, then a couple days later, part three, and like you consistently. I'm so inconsistent that that's what keeps me consistent with putting out new content. I don't feel the pressure to continuously put out part one, two, three, in maybe like a 20-part series. I am so random with it. I might build a Deep Blue Sea set one day and hit you with a, as you can see here in a minute, a Back to the Future arcade the next. And I don't feel as chained down. Like, I know you guys don't expect that from me. So that is what I think, what helps me create this stuff in my own style. It's because you guys are pretty relaxed with my builds and with the actual, like, if I do start a series, you guys don't really... you don't mind the randomness and me jumping around, because you never know, once you get that little bell and you get that little notification, what I've got coming out, it might be something you've never seen before, or it might be a continuation of a series that you enjoy. So let's run through some of these real quick, and this will contribute to some more randomness. And I know you guys gave me really good feedback on the aquarium here. If you haven't seen the video before this, go check it out. It's a whole, review of my thoughts and this aquarium and kind of where I want to go from here. And so, and maybe moving into the swamp after this, doing like a little, little alligator section of the aquarium. So go check that out. This only showed a picture of this, but this is a little, hotel lobby scene that I came up with. Actually, I was just Googling. I don't have the picture pulled up right now, but I just Googled, straight up Googled hotel lobbies, saw a little bit of a design of one like this. Of course, I went ahead and added this this bar over here in the corner of the hotel, the Viper Room, so guests can go in there and get drinks and just hang out, just a bar. and got the big, huge floral art piece. Got some little decorations over here on the table, some plants, got some loungers, big coffee table. And yeah, just wanted to just put together a little hotel scene, see what I could do, see how I could make it look. I've kind of got the exposed, exposed lowered rafters here. Really, really think these rafters, these support beams, really kind of, they just add some depth to the room. I think just because, you know, you can see how much higher the roof is to where the guests are actually standing, adds a lot of presence to the room. Lot of height. I really think that turned out pretty cool. So there's that. If you guys, and I took a lot of the roof pieces off these, so we could get a, you know, jump in here and get a better look quicker without me fumbling around with the cursor and the camera movements. But yeah, this is just my Back to the Future arcade units and front part of the arcade. So, and you know, a lot of this stuff too, I think if I do make it available one day on the workshop, you could use it in queues, or if you've already built your arcade, you could take this and put it in your arcade as your maybe your Back to the Future section. So that's, you know, a lot of this stuff, I know I said at the beginning, a lot of it's maybe not so useful to you. It's just kind of random stuff that I felt like building. But, you know, if you think about it, a lot of this stuff, you could probably use it in ride queues and, you know, different stuff like that. Just a little creepy room right here I put together. I kind of dubbed it the Lady in the Red Room. So that is kind of what I come up with. This was just kind of in a creepy kind of mood. And so the lady kind of watches over this room. I figured you could probably easily turn it into a hallway and be a really creepy hallway. Let's see what we got next here. Oh yeah, you guys really like this. I don't have the twins down right now, but this is just the little remake of the Shining hallway. So you know, you can drop your twins down in there. Actually, what I did was, if you remember, I put a piece of path down and dropped two Princess Amelias down, and they kind of wave and dance in the same spot, and they don't walk away, and they kind of look creepy at the end of the hallway. So yeah, there's that. next really, really fun build right here. This is one of those builds like where I believe Sylv said it a couple days ago in Jägerhorn, that this was one of those builds where I spent hours on it, and it was just one of those builds where I really, really had fun. Like, I remember, it's probably almost a month ago now, but it was a Saturday. It was really raining outside, thundering. There was nowhere to be, nobody to see, and I sat downstairs uninterrupted for like probably 4 or 5 hours just building on this room and changing stuff out. Big shout out to Dirk Techno for letting me bring Bruce in here from his Jaws set, recolored Bruce. And unfortunately he is about to get experimented on. But yeah, this is one of those really fun builds. Spent half the day on it, just was cheesing and grinning. Like, as soon as I got it done, I knew you guys were gonna go crazy for it, and the response was amazing on it. A lot of comments, we set Reddit on fire with this one. A lot of just a really fun build. So here's one of the more recent ones. Let's see if we can get in here. This is kind of like my little Rogue One bridge command center scene. So you know, just a lot of just tomfoolery with billboards and some of the lasers, and you know, just trying not to let the Death Star destroy planets. You know, just average everyday sci-fi stuff. But yeah, this is just a quick scene I put together. Let me see if I can spin around here. Only thing kind of let me down is the billboards. When you have so much black, it seems that it kind of gets really ahead of itself and kind of pixelated. The black turns really dark blue. I think that would have worked out. You guys probably would have accepted that better if it was if that was all black and it looked kind of like the space station was cruising through without so much of that blue like diluting the scene. on that screen. But anyway, still turned out cool. You guys get the idea. They're cruising through space, so there's that. Oh, here's the original. This is like what I did the first evening we had billboards, was I built the Poe. I dubbed it the Poe Living Room. But so yeah, this was it. This is the my first billboard pieces ever, and just it was a lot of fun. I knew right from the beginning, right when I did this, the potential that billboards were gonna have. And even you can see how crappy this looks, but this was at the forefront of my billboard game and my billboard techniques. So, and you know, I say it looks crappy, but what did we get billboards like? I don't even know now. Okay, so it's August. It's the middle of August. Maybe 2 months ago? Maybe a little bit longer? Maybe a little bit shorter? Might not even been that long ago. But, you know, I've come from this to, you know, one of the newer builds. Well, okay, so we come from that, and now we are, now things like this are possible. There goes the Stingray. So you can see as time goes on, we all get better at this, and your techniques get better and practice, and you know, you just gotta keep going. You gotta keep practicing it. Don't give up on it. And here's another scene that you guys, I don't even know if I ever put a picture out of this, because I was just kind of messing around with the Deep Blue Sea scene, and I thought that could probably be easily modified into like a sci-fi like spaceship repair bay, like a repair bay where the ships could just fly up underneath, and the you know, the robots kind of just come out, and the ships can get serviced and repaired. So this was just a total transformation of the Deep Blue Sea set. So yeah, that's where you get from that. And we are getting to our last two interior pieces. This, if you remember, is my little haunted zombie cowboys. They have boarded up here in their cabin, trying to get away from the zombies. Zombie scenes, I got that from you guys might know. If you don't, I'm a huge Halloween fan. Probably my favorite favorite holiday of the year. And usually I have a big party at my house, and I've got a projector. And this is from my Atmos Fear X DVD. So usually this scene right here with the zombies is like projected up on my garage door. So when the kids come up and they're trick-or-treating, they've got these zombies that pop up on the side of the house or the garage door, and they absolutely love it. Same way here, this is actually from that same DVD. It's just the different hidden styles. So this kind of interior, I wanted to do like a kind of like a creepy, really unethical, shady medical center type stuff going on. And I've got the really flipped over the Munsters carriage top and made it kind of like a metal slab operating table. And yeah, you've got the zombies kind of quarantined behind this gate, behind that window. These little professors, they didn't make out too good. So, but anyways, yeah. So this is it, guys. I just wanted to just peel back the curtain a little bit, and yeah, just wanted to show you guys this. And I think I have kept you here for almost 20 minutes now. So we will probably go ahead and jump on out of here. But you know, like always, leave me your comments down below of how you think this turned out. Tell me what your favorite scene is below. And yeah, just give me your general thoughts and feedback on some of these interiors I've put together. And yeah, a lot of times you guys shape these builds, because like if I put it on Reddit or Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, I get a lot of feedback like, oh, you know, Stan Wolf, you should try this, or what if you flip this around? Like, I remember when I first put this picture out, somebody on Facebook said, Steve, the ladder is upside down. So that saved me. I didn't even catch it. Went in, flipped the ladder upside, you know, back to the right way. So I definitely use your guys' feedback. I appreciate it, and you have contributed a lot of ideas that I put into the game. A lot of my random weirdness is actually, you know, it's kind of attributed to you a little bit, so you do kind of have a little bit of stake in my creepiness and my weirdness. So anyways, guys, give me a thumbs up if you end up enjoying this video, and I will speak with you guys next time. Thank you for coming and hanging out with me. And yes, I will catch you in my next video. Thank you. See ya.
Mike, hey.